what I'll do is I'll just list down the classes, interfaces, and the methods that we have discussed so far. Okay, so the first one that we have used is Chrome driver, right? This is the class we have used, and then Firefox driver, and these two parent we used web driver. Okay, so this is interface, this is class, and this is class. All of these classes contain these methods. What is the method that we have used? Get method, and then find element. These are the two methods that we have used. Do you remember of using any other method in the driver? We did not, right? We did not used any other apart from manage and then switch to. Okay, so if you remember, like, where did we use manage? Manage is used for
maximize window.
For implicit wait, the timeouts we have used, and also for window maximize we have used. Those two methods we have used. We'll come there. That is one thing. And then just now we used switch to. So in the switch to, when I call switch to, what it will return is, and just write that object here, that name of that object. Then I'll write the methods here. Okay. When you call get method, it returns void. Okay. When you call web find element, it returns web element. That's what it returns, right? So whenever you see find element, the return type of that is web element. Okay. And then when you call manage, it will return options. Okay, it returns man options. And then when you call switch to, it returns target locator. You can see that here. Switch to will return target locator. Fine. So I don't need to worry about void. I just see web element. In web element, what are all the methods that we have used? We have used clear, okay. We have used clear, we have used click, we have used send keys, we have used get text. Any other methods that we have used here? I hope these three these methods we have used. We have a couple of other methods to be discussed in this. We'll come back to that later. Okay. Now, when you have options, in the options, options object, we have used timeouts, right? If you see here, driver.manage, inside the manage, you call the timeouts method. Timeouts will return an object of timeouts class. Okay, so timeouts, it will return timeouts. Okay, in the timeouts, which methods we have used? We have used implicitly wait. Okay, so we have used implicitly wait. This implicitly wait is the method which will provide us a kind of mechanism that makes your searching, like Selenium will search for an element, right? That searching mechanism, it will wait for the time that you defined in the implicitly wait before throwing no such element exception. So that at the end of your it will make your test case more reliable, or it will not make your test case very fragile by throwing no such element exception even the elements are about to come. Okay, now this is like, it returns web implicitly wait returns void, so it ends there. Okay, there is this another method we have here in this timeout which we have not discussed yet, which is called as a page load timeout. Okay, So page load timeout. I'm just writing out here. Whatever we have discussed, I'll make it as green color. Okay, whatever we have not discussed, we'll make it as yellow color. Okay. Page load timeout. And then one more thing we have is set script timeout. These are the two methods that we have. Yeah, set script timeout. Set script timeout. These are the two methods we have. Okay. Now it returns void and it returns void. Okay. Any questions as of now? What I'm trying to do is I'm trying to prepare a table so that you can refer easily. Okay. For classes, I'll use this blue color. Okay. For classes, for interfaces. So we need to segregate classes and segregate. I'll use this. This is for interfaces. And then web element also interface. And then options also interface. And then target also, target locator. Check it out. How do you know that whether it is a interface or not? If you put here, this is options. This options is interface. I means interface. And then this is timeouts, right? Timeouts is also interface. And then one more thing we have seen is like switch to. Where is the switch to? Yeah, switch to returns target locator. Target locator also an interface. Okay, so timeouts, target locator interface, options interface, then timeouts also interface. So these are all interfaces. Now, yeah, come back to manage. In manage, we have used another method which is called as this window. Okay, so window method returns window object. So windows is also interface. In window, you have seen maximize. So we have manage. In the manage, you call this to set. Yeah, right. Like I have manage. That is the manage method. Manage returns window. Manage manage and call window method. Window returns window object. Okay, so window is the method name, and then it returns window class. Okay, and then window we have used maximize method. Maximize method returns what it returns? It returns void, so it ends there. What does this maximize do? It makes your screen equals to your screen size. Okay. Now we have discussed this. And what else we have in this object is we have set window size. We have, if you see, there is like full screen, and then get position, get size, and then set position and set size. These are the five methods we have there. Okay, so I'll write it down here. Full screen, set, size, get size, set position. We'll discuss them. Okay, set position. Okay. Why I'm trying to tell you here is why I'm trying to prepare this table is it will give you a overall idea of how it will look like, what all the methods you can have in a single position. Okay. Now I have these methods, it will be put it into hello. There are a few other methods we have which we did not discuss. We'll see that later. Okay. Now come to switch to. What do we have in the switch to? So in the switch to, we have called a method called alert. Okay. Alert return alert class. Actually, this alert is a class. So switch to. It returns alert, right? Okay, alert is also interface. I thought it is class. So alert interface, and then we have okay. In this alert, we have three methods. Okay, one is accept, dismiss, and then the other one is get text. Okay, so I'll mark it as green. We discussed about it, right? You can practice it when you'll get that example. Okay. And what are the other classes that we have discussed so far? There are two classes out there, which is actions class, right? So okay, so I have this actions class. Actions class, what it is having, what are all the methods that we have seen in the actions class? You see this? This is this click and hold, context click, double click, drag and drop, key down, key up, move by offset, move to element, okay, purse, perform, release, and then send keys, tick. So these are all the options that or methods we have. I'll just write it down here, okay. So first one is click means normal click, okay. Then context click is right click. You have in the mouse left click and right click, right? So you have context click means right click. Double click means sometimes you have to click two times. Like if you want to open any file, you click on twice, right? That is double click. In Selenium, using click and click does not mean double click. Okay, just remember that. You have to use double click. And then drag and drop. And drag and drop by, there are two methods we have. Where is this? The drag and drop and then drag and drop by, two options are there. Drag and drop by. Okay, so drag and drop means like here I clicked and then dragged and released, right? That is drag and drop. Same thing sometimes you have to do in the UI also, that can be done by using these two methods. And then drag and drop by, after that what we have, okay, key down and key up, move by offset and going move by element. Okay, key up, key down, move by offset. Move by offset means moving your cursor from one place to another place. Okay, move to element. Okay, move to element means placing your cursor there, so that's a kind of a mouse over. And then pause, perform, release, right? Pause, release. Whenever you click, okay, there is another method here, just I forgot to include, which is called as click and hold. Click and hold. Okay, that means click on the one element and then holding it. Okay, and you can perform any other operation and then finally release it. So this will be will come it as a batch or group release. And then what else we have? Send keys tick. Okay, and then what we have, one more, perform. Okay, send keys typing tick, it will perform a small operation, and then build and then perform. Okay, so these are all that methods that are available here. We have seen few. Click, we have seen. Move to element, we have seen. And then key up and key down, we have seen. And then build, we have seen. And then perform, we have seen. Okay. So when it comes to the return type, all these objects, if you see, let's say I called keys down, right? The return type of this key down is actions. Okay. So it's not void. If it is a void, you cannot click on that again. Okay. So the design that they have done is all the methods will return actions object so that they again call any other method which is available in that actions object. So that's why key down returns object of actions. And then it is like, again, you can call send keys. Send keys returns actions object. And then again, you can call key up. And then it returns actions, but this build and perform, only these two differ. All the other methods from here to here, the return type of this is actions class. Okay, so actions object. But build will return, if you see, there is something called action. Instead of actions, there is something called action. Action is an interface. Okay, so it returns the object of action. Okay, this action contains only one method. Okay, this action contains only one method. Okay, which is perform. Okay, when you call build, then you cannot call any other methods like click or send keys or key down, control click. You cannot do anything. Once you call build, that means you can call only method called perform because it returns actions class. This class contain only one method. This, okay, perform return void. So this is an interface we have. Then yeah, we'll discuss about these methods in some other classes. Okay, but remember, this is the class we have used. Any questions here? Okay. And one more class we have used is select. Okay, one more class we have used select. Okay, select contains what? The methods we have seen here is, where is the select? Select equals to new select. And then inside that, we have seen a method called isMultiple. We use isMultiple. It returns Boolean. That means true or false. And then we have seen select by index, select by value, select by visible text. Okay, so select by index, select by value, select by visible text. So these are the methods that we have seen. And then similarly, instead of select, you have deselect. That means once it is selected, you have to deselect to by using these three options. Okay, deselect. And then what else we have here? There are few important methods. These are the deselects, deselect all. Okay, so we select all, that is one method, and get all selected options, get first selected options, get options. Okay, so first one is get options. It will return all the options that are available for that select class. So if you see this page, you have all the options are there, right? How many options? All the countries we have there. Okay, so all the countries, how many options we have, it will give you all the options. Okay, then get options, these all the options will be returned to your class, returned as an option. And then get first selected option will give you only the first one. So if you are select, if it is a multi-select, you select multiple values, it will give you get first selected option. So first option will be returned. Okay, for this the web return type is web element. I'll talk about return types later because I need to discuss few topics here. And then get all select. Get all selected options. So else we have get wrapped element, we don't use it, so just ignore it, this is not required. Okay, select, deselect, deselect all, guest options, first all selected options, that's all. So these are all the methods that are available in our select class. So we have seen this. And we have, you can say that this are all completed. You can practice like you selected, right? In this example, let's say try this. First click on let's say one language, let's say French. It is selected now. So then you can write deselect and click use French. So it should not, it should be deselected. And then you select two. And then call deselect all. That means it should remove all these selections. These two you can practice as an assignment. Okay. I'll tell you all these three options later. Okay. Anything else we have discussed? All right. Okay. I'll share this sheet with you later. Just remember, okay. Selenium. Okay. Any questions here?